anti-police, so I don't feel safe to stand up behind me. You mind standing in the house?
I'm going to stand in my yard if that's okay.
Okay, so remember that video. Emily Good of Rochester, New York, recording police as she stood in her own front yard. Then police put Good under arrest, raising the question, did that officer in particular overstep his authority? Good supporters say yes, he did. And they felt even more justified this week after the charge against her of obstruction of government administration was dropped. Good is on the left there hugging her attorney. But now the police union says officers are in greater danger on the street and that several of them have been threatened.
An example of some of these threats are, I hope this gets killed. I want to see cops like this getting fried and hung in the streets. If you wear a badge, you're a target. I'm going to add, these threats are not the worst threats, and they're not the threats that are being investigated.
All right, so Emily Good joins me now, and we're also talking to Eric O'Brien, a columnist for the Rochester Democrat and Chronicle. Thank you both for joining us. Emily, it wasn't the judge, but the Monroe County prosecutor that dropped the charge. What was your immediate reaction? I mean, you must have felt some sense of, I was right and the officer was abusing his power.
Yes, I was relieved, but I also feel like justice has not been done and that officer has not yet been brought to justice. He still hasn't faced the reality that he committed an unlawful act. And I am also alarmed that the president of the police union maintains that that was a lawful arrest, and he insists that citizens do not have the right to observe or to question police officers.
Okay. We asked the officer who arrested you, and the leaders from Rochester Police and the police union to join us tonight all declined, and they did not respond. But this week, I had to say the union, the Rochester Police Locust Club, right, said, your episode, Emily, has created a defiant and dangerous attitude.
Mrs. Good's message that has gone out to the public is that you have a right to interfere and question the actions of a police officer is irresponsible, is a danger to the officers, the individuals the officers are dealing with, and any other bystanders. A simple street stop can turn deadly in seconds.
Emily, what's your response to that?
If we don't have a right to question police officers, then we're living in a police state. And I absolutely maintain that we have a right to question authority in every level of our government, every civil servant.
Yeah. Erica, as a Rochester native, and you wrote a column there, what do you think about the union statement that it's dangerous for people to interfere with police business? Which, first of all, they're saying she was interfering, but the prosecutor said she was not interfering. But what do you think? Do people have the right to question?
Of course, I do believe that people have the right to question, and that if you are in a situation where you feel that your rights are being violated, you should stand up and say something. But the column that I ended up writing about this incident was my husband and I were talking about Ms. Good and how she stood her ground and how brave that was. But I said that I wouldn't want my son to do that because I would fear for him due to cases like Amadou Diallo, where a man who was reaching for a wallet was actually believed to have been thought to be reaching for a gun and was shot 41 times, and other cases where citizens who have been thought to be confronting the police have had things end badly for them. So though I do believe that people have a right to stick up for their civil liberties, I also believe I would tell my son, I'd say, you know, if you want to stick up for your civil liberties, go to law school, because things can end badly if you are seen to be making police feel unsafe.
I have to ask you, there have been a number of incidents, and some of them chronicled on YouTube and in your particular paper. Is there an issue with Rochester Police? Is it heavy-handedness? Is it racial profiling? What's going on there that seems to be different than many other places? Or is there anything going on that's different?
I don't believe that it's different from many other places. And I believe that, I would say that all of my interactions with Rochester police officers in life have been excellent, and I've never had any problem with any particular Rochester police officer, and I have family who are police officers, but when you see specific incidences where, for example, in a city close to Rochester recently, there was a young man, a young African-American male, who was shot during a police stop, and the police believed he had a gun, but no gun was ever found in the car.
So you were, and listen, I don't have much time here, so what are you saying, that nothing is different in Rochester? Is that, or is there an issue nationwide?
No, I don't think things are different in Rochester.
You're saying you believe there is an issue and not an issue. Is there an issue nationwide and Rochester is no different, or there's no issue at all in Rochester and the police are fair?
Oh, I believe it's an issue nationwide.
Okay. Emily, I have to get to this. There have been some other questionable events involving you and police. Last week, your supporters came together and police came out and issued 5 parking tickets. Look at this real quick.
Oh, really? You had civilian complaints?
You don't think this is going out?
Regarding the parking being further than 12 inches from the curb?
Okay, that's 12 inches from...
You can see the officers brought out rulers showing how far people had parked from the curb. Some say this was police retaliation, and you also had a burglary in your home, and the iPod that was used to shoot your arrest was taken, and police took some time to respond to your home. What do you think? Was it retaliation, the parking, and what do you think happened with your iPod and the police response?
I do feel that the burglary was suspicious, considering my iPod was the thing that was targeted. I can't speculate any further than that on the burglary. I feel like the meeting of my supporters, in which 4 uniformed police officers showed up in 4 patrol cars and issued tickets, is clearly a case of intimidation. There was also an arrest the night of my case's dismissal of a young African-American man who was videotaping the police. Yeah. Again, he was arrested for jaywalking.
And Emily, you're going to sue, right?
Yes.
All right. Thank you, Emily. Thank you, Erica.
Thank you.
Thank you.